A beautiful story comes to my mind, and every time I go to Medina Munawwara and I see this place, tears begin to well in my eyes when I remember what happened that day when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with Mu'adh ibn Jabal. And Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu was a very close companion to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, in many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions his love for Mu'adh, as Mu'adh had an upper hand with the people of Yemen. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose Mu'adh to be a governor in Yemen and to be a teacher in Yemen and to go to Yemen and teach the people about Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells Mu'adh, "Mu'adh, I have chosen you to be that very teacher, to go to Yemen." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on the day that Mu'adh is leaving Medina Munawwara, walks with Mu'adh. He walks with Mu'adh from the vicinity of Medina Munawwara with the animal that Mu'adh will ride. He walks with Mu'adh from the masjid to the outskirts of Medina Munawwara. Today, if you go and visit that very place where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam walked up to with Mu'adh, you will notice a roundabout and on it a gate. And they call it the gate of Medina Munawwara, the entry to Medina. And at this very point, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam turns and looks at Mu'adh. And they've had a beautiful conversation from the masjid up to this area. And believe me, this was quality time. This was time that Mu'adh had spent with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on a personal level. And you will know this, that every sahabi, every companion felt he was the closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Say sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every companion used to feel that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the pinnacle in his life. Every companion felt that they could turn to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for anything and everything. You imagine Mu'adh walking with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In his wonderful relationship with Rasulullah, he walks to the outskirts of Medina and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turns and he says, "Ya Mu'adh," he says, "Asa Allah talqani ba'da ami hadha." He says, "Ya Mu'adh, we will not meet again after this year, Mu'adh." Imagine the feeling that Mu'adh would have had at that moment. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling a man that these guys would die for, every companion would die for Rasulullah, every companion would want to be in front of Rasulullah when spears, when arrows were being thrown at him, just like Talha radiallahu anhu at the time of Uhud, when he was walking to Uhud and they were guarding Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was singing a poem. He was saying, "Al-wajhu liwajhika al-wiqa'u," that ya Rasulullah, today my face for your face is a shield. And every time an arrow or a spear was thrown at Rasulullah, Talha would jump, he would catch it in his body, he became a human shield for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was the love of the companions. Imagine Mu'adh on that day when Rasulullah says to him, "Asa Allah talqani ba'da ami hadha," that, "Oh Mu'adh, I don't think we will meet again after this year." Imagine what Mu'adh felt like. Mu'adh was going hundreds of miles away from Medina Munawwara, away from Rasulullah, away from the Beloved. These men could not bear a morning away from Rasulullah, let alone thousands of miles and years. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him, "La'allaka tamurru bi masjidi wa bi qabri," that, "Oh Mu'adh, when you return, what you will find is my masjid and my grave." And Mu'adh begins to cry. Mu'adh begins to cry that, "Ya Rasulullah, is this the last time that I will see you? Is this it?" And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam begins to cry, knowing that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will never see Mu'adh again. And when Mu'adh gets onto his ride and begins to ride, he cries his journey to Yemen, knowing that the eyes that Allah had bestowed to him had seen Rasulullah for the very last time. When Mu'adh returned, He came and he saw the masjid of Rasulullah. He saw the grave of Rasulullah. He no longer saw Rasulullah. This was a man who was hurt, a man who was in pain. These were all subtle indications towards the fact that Rasulullah would no longer be amongst the Muslims.